Hello friends, how are you all? I hope you all are good. So friends, in this video we are going to discuss about brachiopods. What is their morphology? This we are going to see in this video. This video is going to be a long video. As I promised you all that I will upload videos on paleontology because you all were demanding. So I have made a playlist on paleontology. You can see that there are four or five videos on that. Recently I uploaded a geological time scale, and now this is another video on paleontology. And in this we are going to discuss brachiopods. And what is the morphology of brachiopods? We are going to define morphology of brachiopods, then we will see the terms related to brachiopods. After that we will see their morphology, their detailed morphology. Then we will see the diagram, and finally we will see the distribution of brachiopods in this lecture. So let us start. So what is morphology? The first word written here is morphology, branch of biology that deals with the form of living organisms and with relationship between their structure. It is of that branch that deals with the form, means with the shape and size, with the shape and size of living organism and with relationship between their structure. What is the relationship between this structure? This is seen in this branch. Morphology deals with the form, means shape and size of living organism and relationship between their structures. Next is brachiopods. What is the definition of brachiopods? We all know that brachiopods are animals belonging to the phylum Brachiopoda, and they have a speciality. They are characterized by presence of a shell. If it is a shell, we can identify it that it is a brachiopod. They have hard valves on the upper and lower surfaces. Means the structure is something like this. One is upper valve and another is lower valve. The both valves are connected through an end, and it is located at the back, so that is why it is called hind end. And the front part is, front part can open for feeding and close for protection. Okay, so means generally the brachiopods will have two valves, one upper valve and another lower valve. It means and they are characterized by the presence of a shell. Both valves are unequal. One valve will be gray, one valve will be bigger and another valve will be smaller. Okay, valves are unequal and they are hinged. Hinged means they are connected at the rear end. From behind they are connected, and while the front can be opened for feeding and closed for protection. This I have already told you. Now we will see the terms related to the brachiopod. To study the morphology of brachiopods, here are some terms. The first one is dorsal. Dorsal means upper side or back of an animal or plant. The upper side or the back part means we can say as our back, they also have back. So that part is called dorsal part. Ventral, lower side or underside. Okay, lower side or underside means where their abdomen or stomach is located, that is called ventral part. Anterior is front part nearer to the head, or we can say fore part or foramen. It is also known as foramen. Front part that is nearer to the head is called anterior, fore part or foramen. Posterior, back part nearer to the hind end is called posterior. Okay, articulate and inarticulate. What is articulate? If the valves have tooth and groove, means they have tooth and socket. Socket is the place where tooth fits, is present. It is called articulate. Inarticulate, simple muscles for opening and closing of valves are present. Okay, and the second one is inarticulate. In this, tooth and groove are absent. They are not present. Complex muscle for opening and closing of valves. Hinge line is an imaginary line along the dorsal edge of a bivalve. It is an imaginary line that is present along the dorsal edge of a bivalve. Bivalve means two valves. Okay. Okay, friends, now we are going to discuss the morphology of a brachiopod. What is their morphology? The important features of a brachiopod cell are as follows. The cell is equilateral and unequal. The cells are equilateral. Equilateral means they have the sides are equal. Suppose this is the cell. Their sides will be it is something like this. So the sides are generally equal and unequal. What is unequal? Valves are unequal. Okay. Second part. both valves are produced into what called a beak or ambo each. Okay, both the valves, see suppose there are two valves, this is the upper valve, this is the lower valve. Okay, so both the valves are produced, they are produced and into what is called beak or ambo. They are produced and the when they are produced, one structure, pointed structure comes out, and that pointed structure is called beak or ambo. Okay, they mark the posterior end of the shell. The beak mark the posterior end, means back part of the shell, because it is situated in the back part. It comes like this and like this. So this is the back part. The ambo of the ventral valve is more prominent than that of the dorsal valve. This means the ambo or the beak of the ventral valve is bigger than that of the dorsal valve. Okay, third point is the surface of the shell is nearly smooth. The surface is nearly smooth. The surface of shell is nearly smooth, but at irregular intervals, it is marked by concentric growth lines, which are parallel to shell margin. I will show you this by diagram, then you will understand it better. Yeah, this is the diagram. So the first point that I told you, that the cell is in equilateral. The cells are in equilateral, means their sides are generally equal, and valves are unequal, means these valves are unequal in shape. You can see in this diagram, this is the side view of the this is the upper valve, this is the lower valve, and so this is the side view. Generally the bracket ports are like this, means this is the, they are kept like this when they are kept in a two-dimensional space, but this is its side view. Okay, so the point was the valves are unequal. So you can see this valve start from here and ends at here, and this valve start from here and ends at here. So this valve is bigger and this valve is smaller. Okay, both valves are produced into what called beak or ambo. Okay, both valves have beak, a pointed part, and that pointed portion is called beak or ambo. Okay, they mark the posterior end of the shell. The beak or ambo show the posterior end, means back part. This is the back part of the shell. Because this back part is coming like this, and so this is the beak. So this marks the posterior end, means back part of the shell. Okay, let us move ahead. The ambo of the ventral valve is more prominent than that of the dorsal valve. First, let us learn what is ventral valve and what is dorsal valve. We have already learned that in the definition that I showed you here. Okay, ventral, lower side or underside of an animal is called ventral valve. So abdominal part or stomach part, where its abdominal or stomach part is situated, that is called ventral valve. So the lower side, you can see this is the lower side, here it is its stomach or abdominal part is situated. This is called ventral valve, and this is larger than the dorsal valve, and this valve, upper valve, is called dorsal valve. This is the back part of this animal. Okay, so the ambo of ventral valve, the beak of this valve is bigger than that of the dorsal valve. The next point I told you there was that the surface of the shell is nearly smooth, but at irregular intervals it is marked by concentric growth lines. If we see the posterior part of the shell, then it is saying that the surface is generally smooth. When you touch it, it feels smooth, but at regular intervals there are some lines that mark the growth of the animal. These lines are called growth lines, and growth lines are parallel to each other. Okay, growth lines are parallel to each other. This was the next point, which are parallel to the shell margin, and they are also parallel to the shell margin. This is the cell margin. Margin of cell means end of the cell. So these are the growth lines. Okay, let us move forward. Covering of deltherium is called deltidium, and that of nototherium is called chelidium. Before learning that, we should learn what is deltherium and what is nototherium. So let directly come to the seventh point. Directly beneath the beak, the inter area either valve may be interrupted by triangular Okay, the inter area of either valve may be interrupted by triangular open space, and open space termed as del theorem in the ventral valve and noto theorem in the dorsal valve. This means, see this diagram, when it is like this. So it is saying that this is a beak, it's a beak, okay. The part directly below the beak, so this is the part that is below the beak. If we see from side, it is triangular in shape, triangular interspace means there is triangular open space in between them. Okay, there is triangular open space. This triangular open space directly below the beak of the directly below the beak is called what? This open space is called deltherium in the upper part, termed as deltherium in the ventral valve. Okay, it is this open space is termed as deltherium in the ventral valve and nototherium in the dorsal valve. So if we see this, so this is the upper part. Okay, so so this is the dorsal valve and this is the triangular space like this. It is make, if we see, it is making a triangle. So this triangular space below the under the dorsal valve, under the dorsal valve is called nototherium, and under the under the ventral valve it is called deltherium. Okay, under the dorsal valve it is called, this triangular space under the dorsal valve is called nototherium, and under the ventral valve, okay, means under the this below valve, this triangular space is called, triangle open space is called deltherium. Okay, covering of the deltherium is called deltidium, and covering of the deltherium is called deltidium, and that of nototherium is called a chelidium. The covering of deltherium, okay, yeah, deltherium is the space here. The covering of deltherium, this covering of deltherium is called deltidium, and covering of nototherium, the open space present in the above valve is chelidium. Okay, next one, in the inarticulate brachypodes. Inarticulate brachypodes are those brachypodes in which tooth and socket or tooth and groove are absent. The muscles which open the valves are called diductors, and those which close them are known as adductors. ADDUCTORS. Okay, in articulate brachypodes, the muscles which open the valves are called diductors. So in this diagram you can see these are the diductor muscle, the muscle that is coming this muscle is diductor muscle that is that is pointed at above and open at lower part. This is diductor muscle, and this one is the adductor muscle. Okay, so this point says that the muscles which open the valves, the muscle which help in opening, are called diductors. This muscle helps in opening the valve, and the muscle that help in closing the valve, this muscle is called adductor muscle. Okay, next point, through the foramen of the ventral valve, a muscular stalk which extrudes get attached to the substratum. This is known as pedicle. Through the foramen, through the front part of the ventral valve. So this is the ventral valve. Through its front part, a muscle extrudes. Okay, a muscular stalk means a muscular piece that comes out, which extrudes. Matlab that comes out. That is called pedicle. So this is this muscular part here, and which is connected to this substratum. So means this sublayer is called pedicle, and it is coming out from this gap. So this was this point. This I have already explained you, deltherium, nototherium. So let us move to the next one. Sometimes the teeth are supported by plates known as dental plate. The plate that supports teeth are called dental plate. Inside the shell of the brachypods, the following organs are found to be present beside those which have been described earlier. Organs other than that we have discussed earlier are are the following? Crure, CRURE, median septum, septilal plates, spondylium, brachydium, which consists of a pair of simply curved on doubly bent arms known as loops. Okay, brachydium consists of a pair of simply curved and doubly bent arms known as loops. So brachydium are generally the arms that are doubly bent. They are bent two times and as they are in the form of loops. And the skeletal connections joining both the arms are known as jugum. And the skeletal connections that join both the arms are known as jugum. You can see in this diagram, this is a socket. So this part that is turning like this is crure. This in between is median septum. And this connection in between these doubly bent loops, you can see this is a loop-like structure. This loop-like structure is the brachydium. Okay, brachydium. And this connection between them is called jugum. Okay. On the external surface of the valve, sometimes ridges are formed. Ridges means upliftment are formed, which extend radially from beak. If this is the beak, they extend like radius from this. Okay, from the beak. Sometimes there occurs radial ribs, as we humans have ribs, these have radial ribs, spines, knobs, which ornament the external surface of the shell. They decorate this outer part of the shell, just as jewelry decorates humans. So these are called ornaments, okay, ornaments of the shell. The shell form of the brachypods may be, that means the shape of the shell may be elongated, ellipsoidal, subcircular, oblate, O-B-L-A-T-E, concave, convex, biconvex, O will not come here, plano-convex, etc. When the cells are found to possess minute holes, they are known as punctuate cells. If cell is having holes, it is called punctuate cell. The junction between the valves is known as commissure. Junction means the connection between both the valves is known as commissure. The initially formed cells are called protegulum, P-R-O-T-E-G-U-L-U-M. The means the cells that are formed at beginning are called protegulum. The older the age, the cells become thick. Means the older is the age, the cell, the thicker is the cell. And their margins truncated and their margins become short. Now we will see that now we are moving to the last part of this video, and this is the geological distribution of brachiopod. They are confined to mostly marine environment, means they are confined to the environment where water is present, hence are found to be present in rock of marine nature. They are found in the rock of marine nature, means in those rocks where the quantity of water is also present. In geological time scale, they are seen in the lower Cambrian, as in some examples here are Lingulella, Cutorgina, Obolella, etc. Okay. The geological ranges of some important species are as follows. This is the geological ranges of these species in the geological time scale. Productus ranges from Carboniferous to Permian. Orthis ranges from Ordovician to Silurian. Spirifer ranges from Silurian to Permian. Atrypa ranges from Ordovician to Devonian. Ryan Connella ranges from Jurassic, is only present in the Jurassic. And Terbretula ranges from Eocene to Pliocene, and Terbretella ranges from Triassic to present day, means they are still present. And these are the diagrams. So friends, I hope you would have liked the video, you would have enjoyed. On your demand, I made this video. Because as you all were asking for the notes of paleontology, so I did hard work and made these notes. Okay, so friends, keep on subscribing, like the video. If you have liked the video, then just press the like button, comment more topics that you want, on which you want video. So this is the end of this video. Keep watching. Thank you.